Hey y'all, and welcome to Gemini Outdoors. Today we'll be continuing our Theory of Life video series on mass shootings. This is in response to the Orlando mass shooting. Well, it's happened again. And to start off with, my heart goes out to the victims of the shooting in Orlando. It's just horrible. As soon as I heard about it, I was just like, it's just awful. You know, they're now gays and lesbians, bisexuals and transgender people were being targeted by radical Islamic terrorists, jihadists, as I call them. And just awful. It's awful. I have some friends who are gay, and you know, they're really wonderful people. And I was thinking to myself, they could have been, you know, they could have been in that club, and it just breaks my heart to think about. And I hope that they're taking measures to protect themselves, because they're definitely targets now. So of course, it's not even, I think it's been 2 days since the attack, and of course the gun control nuts have come out in full force. And of course now we have to, yet again, millions of law-abiding good people, gun owners, good people who have had absolutely nothing to do with what happened in Orlando, have to defend ourselves yet again for the actions of a few. I really don't have any talking points. I really wasn't planning on making this a four-part series. But since this has happened and all these issues have been brought up, I figured that it would be a good opportunity to delve into some numbers and kind of put my thoughts out there on the subject. Everybody knows where I stand. I'm a strong Second Amendment supporter. I believe that we have the right to keep and bear arms, just as it says in the Bill of Rights. And I'm going to get to all that stuff here in a minute. Someone I know sent me a couple of pictures on Facebook. I think they're called memes. And it pissed me off. I'll just be honest with you. It comes from a Facebook site called Occupy Democrats. I'm going to be picking up my clipboard here. So I'm going to hold these up. And I'm going to address them one at a time. Let's see, which one do I want to start with? Like I said, this is kind of off the cuff, so I'm going to start with this one. Y'all just check this out. If you can't read it, I'll read it for you here in just a minute. It says, "Dear gun nuts, does this look like a well-regulated militia to you? There will always be crazy people. Why do we have to give them assault rifles? This is not what the Founding Fathers intended." This really grips my ass. To that I respond this: "Dear gun control nuts, this is what unregulated evil people look like. Yes, there's always been crazy people. And our Founding Fathers knew that and gave us the Second Amendment to protect ourselves with. Because contrary to what all these progressive socialists, as I'm now going to call them, because that's what they are, want you to believe, you are your number one first responder. You are your number one responsibility in life is to protect yourself. and your family and your property. That's why they wrote the Second Amendment in there. And I don't care what Bill O'Reilly says. I was listening to his comments about it before I started making this video. He's talking about a well-regulated militia that gives them power to regulate the militia, the people and all that. You know, he's going on about tanks and mortars and all this other stupid shit that he ought to know better than even be saying. So I'm pretty sure he's flipping. He's going over to maybe the anti-Second Amendment side, or he's getting just a little bit, you know, tipping his finger in it or something, you know. But common sense, and I think the Founding Fathers knew this, were the Second Amendment. I'm gonna get to that here in a minute. Where the Second Amendment's concerned, common sense tells you that as technology progresses, I hate to say that word, advances, they took that into account when they wrote the Second Amendment and the Constitution in general. They knew that. And they keep going back, the gun control nuts keep going back, and the anti-self-defense nuts keep going back to a well-regulated militia. Like I said, these are unregulated evil people. Do you really think gun control would have stopped these guys? It wouldn't. Every one of these mass shooters here, I'm pretty sure the majority of them were in gun-free zones. I'm going to get to that. They were in gun-free zones. Hell, the attack in Paris was in a gun-free country, one of the most strictest gun control countries on earth. They still got them in through an unsecured border. Sound familiar? Look at our border with Mexico. You really think that drug dealers wouldn't sell guns to their gun dealers over here? I mean, their drug dealers over here. You really think that these guys wouldn't have been able to gotten an assault rifle, or a so-called assault rifle? You really believe that? Okay, I got some oceanfront property in Arizona to sell you. Then they would have found a way. It's even been said that in some of these terrorist magazines, that they say if you can't get a gun, use a truck. Run over people. It wasn't too long ago that a drunk lady run over a bunch of people at a college football game. I can't remember which college it was, but I remember she killed quite a few people. Injured a lot more just with a truck. So, well, what are we going to do? We're going to ban trucks? That's a public safety issue. That's what, you know, Bill O'Reilly and all these other folks have been talking. Well, not so much Bill O'Reilly. I don't want to jump on him too much. I think that he's trying to put some common sense to it, but it's not kind of working for him. You know, it's just amazing to me how we forget that these gun-free zones allow these people to shoot in one direction and not stop. Do they just keep on shooting? I mean, how many times do I have to go back? Did you see the Paris video where the guy walked up to the girl who's crouching with her hands over her head at the cafe or the restaurant? He puts the AK-47 up to her head. She was a sitting duck. He pulled the trigger and the gun didn't go off. Luckiest woman on the face of earth, in my opinion. But anyways, getting back to these other morons right here on this paper. Gun control nuts and anti-self-defense nuts. If you have to post this on your website, the pictures of these mass murderers to make a point, you're glorifying what these monsters did. Look at these. I want to burn them. I don't even like the idea of holding these monsters up here, because it's still glorifying me that much more, even though I'm defending my position. They call us monsters. I'm getting to that. You hang on. I'm fixing to drop your jaws for you. So enough with that one. And bring this one up. Here's another one. They got Mitch McConnell. Picture of Mitch McConnell, and it says, "Sure, we'd love to stop mass shootings." It goes on to say here, Occupy Democrats yet again. I really hope that people will visit this website and really start hammering these people for this. This is bullshit. But we must respect a poorly written constitutional amendment that refers to barely functioning muskets. Okay, let's get to that real quick. So here it is, ladies and gentlemen, the Bill of Rights. Amendment 2, a well-regulated militia being necessary to the security of a free state. The right of the people to keep and bear arms shall not be infringed. Being necessary to the security of a free state. Right there, in a nutshell. Broad language. There's a reason why the founders wrote this amendment in a broad language. Security of a free state. That means for the security of a free state, the people have the right to keep and bear arms, to protect themselves, and to protect their country. If the time, God forbid, ever comes. Remember, we had been invaded by Great Britain. When they wrote this document, we had been invaded. Who protected ourselves? How do we protect ourselves? With the guns that we had on hand at the time. Whether they be rickety muskets or an AR-15 or an AK-47. Because guess what? I mean, we could be invaded today. We're being invaded by jihadists. Radical Islam. We're being invaded right now. What do you think's going on? It's two attacks. Two attacks on the United States. So doesn't it make sense that if a terrorist has got a gun and they're coming at you, doesn't it make sense? Wouldn't you hope that you had a gun on you to where you could try to defend yourself? These people in this club, these poor people, had no way of defending themselves. Because they were in a gun-free zone, apparently. Now, I've heard conflicting stories reported in the news that they had a pat-down section. So if they've got a pat-down, a little room or a section in the club where they're patting you down, that means that it's a gun-free zone. You're not supposed to have weapons in there, right? Yet again, here we are, gun-free zones. Let me set this out. There's something else that my gun control nuts need to hear. Okay, well, here we go, see. The Declaration of Independence. Another one of those little inconvenient documents that our founders wrote. It says this: we hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal, that they are endowed by their Creator with certain unalienable rights. Among these are life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. In there it is inferred that if you have a life, you have a right to defend that life from someone who's trying to take it away. You have a right to defend your liberty if someone is threatening to take it away. And you have a right to defend your pursuit of happiness if someone is trying to take that away. It's called inferred rights. Check it out. They exist. The right to defend yourself is universal. Every person who gets attacked tries to defend themselves. And if you're being attacked by a person with a gun, then you have the right to defend yourself with a gun. Whether that be a single-shot musket, a rickety old musket, or an AR-15 rifle. Whichever one you happen to have on you at the time. Alright, so I did this in the video before. I'm going to probably release all these videos at once. I wasn't planning on doing that, so let me get back to this. So I looked up some numbers. And I decided that I needed to look some of this stuff up, and I went on to mostly government websites. I've already talked about this in a previous video, but I think it's worth saying again. Mass shootings in 2014, the way that the progressive socialists make you believe, people are just being shot everywhere. Oh my God, there's thousands and millions of people dying out here by these mass shooters with these assault rifles. Blah-dee, blah, 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 blah. Mass shootings in the year 2014, I've already gone over why these years are 2014, 2013. Mass shootings, 160 incidents. 486 people were killed, 557 were injured in 160 incidences by FBI.gov. Go look it up yourself. I'm not going to sit here and argue the numbers with you. Go look it up yourself. Okay, I looked up some other things. I'm not going to get into a lot of this stuff. Distracted driving, I think, is a good one. Because they always use public safety as their excuse for banning guns. It's public safety. It's got to be about public safety. All these law-abiding gun owners, they're just such a threat to our existence. And yet, as far as I can tell, law-abiding gun owners, I mean, I'll get to that in a minute. Let me just get back to my point here. According to distraction.gov, distracted driving in 2014 killed 3,179 people and injured 431,000. So we're talking about public safety. Let's ban cell phones. Let's ban food, McDonald's, fast food. Let's ban music. Let's ban cars. Because that's our line of thinking, right? It's public safety. Am I right? Am I right, Bill O'Reilly? Let's go to something else. Bicycles. The National Highway Traffic Safety Administration. Let's talk about that. Bicycles. In 2013, 743 people were killed in bicycle accidents. 48,000 people were injured. Are we going to ban bicycles? Because that's a public safety hazard. You get where I'm coming from? This is their line of thinking. This is the progressive socialist line of thinking. It's for the better good. Okay. Unintentional falls. I've covered all this in the last video. I know I sound repetitive, but I'm trying to make a point here. CDC.gov, 30,208 people lost their lives to unintentional falls. So we're going to ban ladders and skyscrapers and all high places. How we plan on doing that? It's a public safety hazard. Sometimes maybe you think people should use some common sense. You know, maybe, you know, they say, oh, it's common sense to ban guns, but all you're doing is taking the guns out of the people who are obeying the law. Instead, we're going to let the criminals have all the guns. Really? That's what you're telling me, really? Okay. Unintentional poisoning, 38,851 people lost their life, CDC.gov. So we're going to ban chemicals now. Okay, let's go down here to firearm homicides in the year 2014, FBI.gov. Go visit the website, you'll find it. Total firearms. 11,961. Man, you'd think, you know, with all these crazy law-abiding gun owners out here, that there would be a lot more than that. I'm not diminishing that these are bad numbers. I'm not. This is horrible. I'd rather see that number be zero. As a law-abiding gun owner and a good person, I don't want anyone to lose their life with anything. But I'm not trying to make a point here. Knives and cutting instruments, 1,567. Blunt objects, which would include hammers, 435 people lost their lives. Beatings with just using your fists and your feet, 660. I was actually surprised at that number, but yeah, 660 people lost their lives. We're going to continue this now. So I want you, because I'm about to kind of drop it here for you. Okay, so I went ahead and I said, okay, I'm going to look up some more stuff. Now, this is according to CDC.gov, as reported by CNSnews.com. Now, this was a report authorized by President Obama by the CDC to invest it, to look into gun violence. And here is what, surprisingly, what they said. Now, bear with me. Let's make sure I'm on the right paper here. Studies that directly, I'm quoting here, studies that directly assess the effect of actual defensive uses of guns. Incidents in which a gun was used by the crime victim in the sense of attacking or threatening an offender, a criminal, have found consistently lower injury rates among gun-using crime victims compared with victims who used other self-protective strategies, which means they didn't have a firearm. The CDC study entitled Priorities for Research to Reduce the Threat of Firearm-Related Violence states, violent crimes, including homicides specifically, have declined in the past 5 years. Also pointed out that some firearm violence results in death, but most does not. Wow. In fact, the CDC report said most incidents involving the discharge of firearms do not result in a fatality. Wow. Here we go. Quoting again. In 2010, incidents in the U.S. involving firearms injured or killed more than 105,000 Americans, of which there were twice as many non-fatal firearms-related injuries, 73,505, than deaths. Okay. The Institute of Medicine and National Research Council released the results of their research through the CDC last month. Researchers compiled data from previous studies in order to guide future research on gun violence, noting that, quote, almost all national survey estimates indicate that defensive gun uses by victims are at least as common as offensive uses by criminals. Wow. With estimates of annual uses ranging from about 500,000 to more than 3 million per year. 3 million times a year, estimated, people use a firearm to defend their lives successfully. That's something you don't hear about by these gun control nuts now, is it? They don't want you to hear that. The mainstream media don't want you to hear that. The New York Times, you can go on their website and look. They say that, oh, this is an all-out lie, but this is coming from the CDC, from a report authorized by President Obama himself, Mr. Gun Control himself. It goes on. Most felons report obtaining the majority of their firearms from informal sources, which means they got it from somebody else, illegally. Adds the report, while stolen guns account for only a small percentage of the guns used by convicted criminals. So what they're basically doing is they're going out, finding somebody who doesn't know what their background is, and they're saying, oh, we're going to get that gun, you know, can I buy this gun? They get it, which is an illegal transfer, and then they turn around and they commit the crime, or they go steal a gun to commit the crime with. So, how about that? Researchers also found that the majority of firearms deaths are from suicide, not homicide. Between the years, now pay attention to this, okay? Between the years of 2000 and 2010, firearms-related suicides significantly outnumbered homicides for all age groups, annually accounting for 61% of the more than 35,600 people who died from firearms-related violence in the United States. So in that 10-year period, 335,600 people died. Out of those 335,600 people who died, 204,716 suicides were included in this. That brings the number to actual homicides in a 10-year period to 130,884 homicides in a 10-year period. That's bad. That's real bad. But I'm about to get to something. The progressive socialists, the progressives, kind of use this a lot. Against us, the law-abiding gun owner. They say, oh, you know, there's carnage in the streets. There's people dying everywhere, and it's the legal gun owner's fault. It's the legal gun owner's fault. It's not the criminals. It's not these terrorists that the president even will not even call that was in this case in Orlando. It's not those guys. It's the legal, law-abiding gun owner, the good guys. It's y'all good guys' fault. So I looked something up. On a whim. There are between 250 and 280 million firearms in the United States. Billions of rounds of ammunition. Billions of rounds of ammunition. There are between 120 and 150 million firearms owners in the United States. And it is estimated that between 40 and 50% of all households owns a firearm. That's a lot of people. It's a lot of legal gun owners. Folks, if we were the problem between the estimated 250 million firearms and the 150 million firearms owners, and the billions of rounds of ammunition, I think you know it. It would be all-out war in the streets. That's not what this is right now. I mean, if we really wanted to make a fuss, think about that. So we're the problem. We're the monsters. We're the problem. And yet, for the most part, there is rule of law in the United States. It's not like The Walking Dead, you know. It's not like, you know, Red Dawn and all that, where there's just, you know, stuff going on everywhere. I mean, there's not chaos in the streets for the most part. We live under rule of law, but you would think if we are the monsters, if we're the problem, that if gun owners were the problem, man, you would think we're just not doing a good job of stirring up trouble for some reason. I wonder why. Maybe it's because we're the good guys. We believe in rule of law. We don't want to see anyone get killed. We don't want to see anyone get robbed. We don't want criminals to run amok in our streets. We have the right to defend ourselves. A right, not a privilege. And I don't care what anybody says. The gun control nuts and the anti-self-defense nuts, they want to take all guns away. Everything. They even talking about regulating air guns. BB guns, for God's sake. So they make out this big, we're so monstrous, you know, because of the 335,600 firearms-related deaths. Now, like I said, that's from 2000 to 2010. And according to their own study, and I cover this, it says that it has that homicides have declined. I took a look at my, you know what, since they're going to talk about us as like we're monsters, then I'm going to take the signature piece of legislation that the progressive left and the progressive socialists absolutely love to defend all the time, the way we defend our Second Amendment. Roe v. Wade. I took a long, hard look at it. CDC.gov, go look it up yourself. I want you to look all this stuff up yourself. I've said it in a previous video, I'm saying it in this one. Abortions for the year 2012. I looked it up. And this was on a down year, folks. It's right there. It's right there on the website. Look it up. I beg you, look it up. When I look at this number, it just 699,202 legal abortions in the year 2012 alone, and this was in a declined year. So from a 10-year period, from 2000 to 2010, 335,600 people died, the majority of them from suicide. Homicides were 100, actually over a 10-year period. I'm not going to count the suicides, I'm just going to say the homicides. Because that's the ones that they're always complaining about, right? The mass shootings. 130,884 homicides in a 10-year period. Look at this abortion number in 1 year. Remember, abortion has been legal, I think, since the 70s. You can check that, fact check that, please. I'm sure somebody will. Fact check it. So, me being who I am, I decided, you know what, I'm going to take this number. I'm going to take, I took 699,000. Legal abortions, and that used that. Okay, that's what I'm going to define as a yearly average here. And I estimated the number of abortions over a 10-year period, and I came up with this number. 6,990,000 estimated abortions over a 10-year period. That's just 10 years. It's been lots more than that since abortion has been legalized in this country. Okay, I ain't got the exact numbers on the Holocaust, but there was 4 million people died in the Holocaust. And yeah, I am comparing it to the Holocaust because I do believe this is genocide. These are people. These are human beings that are dying. They're not just bunches of cells. They're inside a human being that's a developing human being. Seriously? We're the monsters? We're the monsters. Think about that number for a minute, folks. That's genocide. I'm talking about over a 10-year period. That's not even as long as abortion has been legalized. And then you take a look at these firearms, the 130,884 homicides over a 10-year period. And the left is calling us monsters. The progressive socialists are calling us monsters. Whoopi Goldberg is calling us monsters, and she don't want to hear about it. Well, how about you take a signature issue of your own and talk about it? Defend that. Defend that. Over a 10-year period, almost 7 million. How can you defend that? Oh, well, they were unwanted pregnancies. They were still human beings. Muslims looked at the gays in that nightclub. This Muslim asshole who went in this club and shot these people, these poor gay people up, thought they were unwanted. It says in the Quran to kill them. I guess according to which version you want to read or whatever, but according in the Quran it says to kill them. There's some Christians that believe that. And they're all sick. They're all evil. I'm not going to say sick. They're evil. Evil people believe that. Okay? Evil people believe that. And I just sit here and I look at this number and I'm just like, how can you defend almost 7 million abortions? Let me be correct here. 6,990,000 estimated abortions over a 10-year period. That's genocide numbers. How do you defend that? You want to make guns an issue? Okay, we're going to make abortion an issue since y'all stand by it so much. This is sickening. Sickening. And remember, we're talking about 150 million firearms owners. Legal, law-abiding firearms owners in the United States. And we're the monsters? We're the ones that are killing millions of people? We're killing millions of human beings over a period of 10 years. When I've got the numbers right here, I just gave you the numbers. From the CDC itself, there ain't no getting out of it. These are the numbers. Except for the estimated one that I did. But I'm taking that over a 10-year period. This 699,202 is in a down year. So I'm actually underestimating it. Think about what I'm saying, people. It's unbelievable. And then they want to call us the monsters. They want to put these memes all over Facebook. They the mainstream media, the progressive socialist media, as I'm going to call them from now on, want to paint this picture that we're the problem. Really? Why don't you report on this? Oh, they were just little bundles of cells that didn't, you know, they're not human beings. Bullshit. I'm calling bullshit what it is, and that's bullshit. Sorry to get my language, but I'm kind of pissed off about this. When you sit there and you look at the numbers, how can you defend this? Honestly. And at sometime in the future, you're going to be standing before God, whichever God that you pray to. You're going to be standing before him, or if you don't, you know, you, if you're atheist, I guess you just answer to whatever. But you're going to have to stand, you know, would I take that chance to stand before God and say that I killed a child, a human being that was going to grow up? Instead, I killed it when it was in its womb. I don't think I could do that. I know I can't do that. And I sit here and I look at these numbers, and I'm like, really? We're the monsters. And, you know, that's not what I'm seeing, and that's going by the numbers. I don't, you know, but you defend that. Defend that. You know, and yeah, I'm raising it as an issue now, because if you're going to yap at us about these mass shootings and stuff, which I've just proven how, you know, I mean, really, abortions. You know, and I'm sure people are going to fly in and you're going to say, oh, you're a hater or whatever, but I'm just pointing out the numbers. You can look them up yourself. And I'm not talking to the people on the left. They already got their mindset. I'm talking to you, the one who's in the middle, who's sitting there like, well, I don't know where I want to fall, what side of the fence I want to fall on. Look at these numbers and ask yourself, could you live with yourself? Not even if you're standing before God, could you live with yourself? People talk about how evil the Nazis were, and they are. Absolutely, they're evil. These numbers rival that. I'm comparing it to Nazism. Because the same people that were, you know, the Nazis that was killing the Jews and they're undesirable people, these are undesired people. Where's the difference? They were a lump of cells. Well, so were the people who were killed back in World War II. They were a group of cells. I'm a group of cells. You're a group of cells. What's the difference? Because I have a conscience and I'm thinking, who says, how do you know that little bundle of cells in that womb doesn't have a conscience? How do you know? Well, science says this and science says that. Really? Science says that 699,202 legal abortions happened in the year 2012. That's 6,699,202 homicides that weren't reported as homicides because they're considered legal. It was perfectly okay while the Nazis were conducting their Holocaust and a reign of terror across Europe. It was completely legal until somebody stepped in with a gun and said, no, we're not going to put up with this no more. I mean, I'm just pointing it out. I'm making an argument. If you can, you know, you argue about us defending the Second Amendment, and here you defend this. Defend this. The problem with this is that it's become socially, it's accepted in society now by some people, not myself. I think abortion is horrible, and with a few exceptions, it shouldn't be allowed, in my opinion. That's my opinion. But I'm not going to force my opinion on other people. And that's what the progressive socialists, the progressive left, want to do to us. They want to force their opinion on us that, hey, you ain't got to defend your life. You know what? That's your choice. You don't have to defend your life. You know what? You don't have to buy a gun. You don't have to. But me, I choose to. I choose to. It's your ultimate responsibility to yourself and to your family. So don't get crying to me when something happens to you. It's your responsibility. You are your first responsibility is to protect yourself. All right. This was more of a rant than it was anything, because you know, these memes or whatever the fuck they're called. Sorry for the language, folks, but I got fired up. Are despicable. It just fired me up, and I started thinking about things. I'm like, you know what? If they're going to put our feet to the fire and make us defend the Second Amendment, then we need to make them defend their own little genocide they got going on with their you know, their Roe versus Wade thing, their abortion thing. Justify that. I just gave you the numbers. Look them up. Like I said, look them up. CDC.gov. You can look up other information. I think I gave them to you. FBI.gov. Please do the research yourself. Don't go to New York Times. Don't go to a right leaning to the, you know, something, some website leaning to the right or leaning to the left. Go to the CDC, the gov, the hard numbers. And the reason why I did choose the 2012, 13, 14 years is because those are more solid numbers, because remember, these stats do change from time to time because of different types of cases that are being solved, criminal cases and whatnot. So those numbers do fluctuate. But that's why I chose those numbers, because 2016 is still going on, and 2015 was last year, so those numbers are really not that solid. That's why I chose that. Like I said, you know, I just get sick and tired of people making me defend myself and defend the Second Amendment. And I just want the Democrats or the progressive socialists that they are now and the progressive left to have to defend something of their own. And those numbers, I mean, bear that out. Think about that. 3 million times a year. From between 500,000 to 3 million times a year, somebody defends themselves with a firearm. Most of the time, not lethally. Think about that. I mean, you know, we're monsters. We have almost 300 million times a year we could shoot someone, but we choose not to. Wow, that's something right there. That really speaks a lot to the legal gun owner, to the good people of this world, who said, you know what, I could kill you, but I'm going to show you mercy by letting you run off, and I'm going to call the police and I'm going to report you instead of shooting you dead like I could. I mean, but you don't hear about that. The mainstream media, the progressive left media, the progressive socialist media don't want you to know that. And it takes people like me working on a YouTube channel to get these numbers out there, to look them up. I looked them up myself, spent my time to look this up and to respond to these people. And to the people who sent me these memes or whatever you want to call them. Really? You have to make your point by glorifying mass murderers? I didn't even want to put them up. I just put them up because I wanted you to see it yourself. I'm not glorifying these guys. These guys, it's ridiculous. It's ugly. It's ugly. I didn't even want to put them up. I'm going to burn them after I get through with this. That's how disgusting it is to me to see the faces of these murderers, these evil people who didn't give these good people a chance. Here a good person is 3 million times a year. You know, like I said, that could be one heck of a statistic if ever one of those guys, incidences that happened there got shot. I mean, think about that. That tells you the difference between an evil person and a good person. A good person, you know, they actually gave an evil person, a criminal, and yet I call them evil, a criminal, leeway, gave them a chance to straighten their lives up. But an evil person, this evil person goes into a nightclub and shoots 49 people, didn't allow them to have a chance. In a school, shot 20-something kids and teachers. Didn't give them a chance. San Bernardino shot them. Did they give them a chance? Do you see why good people need to be armed with AR-15s or whatever they can get their hands on when we're having to deal with criminals and terrorists? And who knows, eventually in the future, we could be invaded. We could be talking about an invading army. If it's gotten that bad, the only people who's left to fight, if our army has been, you know, decimated, it'll be up to us. I mean, think about that. That's what happened in the Revolutionary War. People with their you know, rickety muskets grew a set of balls, grew a backbone that most progressive socialists don't have. You know, they'll hide behind their security guards, won't they? You know, we protect, I think I even said that, we protect our banks, we protect our jewelry stores, we protect our politicians with armed security, and they're more than willing to hide behind them men. But when it comes to us, when we have to provide our own security, guess what? They don't want us having those same firearms. Oh, no, no, no. Well, why don't we take your, and Donald Trump said this, and I applaud him for it. Why don't we take your armed security away from you? If you want to take away the Second Amendment, why don't we take away your security, and let's see how you like it. All right, now that I'm through ranting, I just wanted to say thank you for viewing this. Again, I want to say how sorry I am and how my heart goes out to the victims of this terrible, terrible terrorist attack. It's just heartbreaking to me and to millions of legal gun owners out there that will tell you the same thing. And I just wanted to thank you for watching Gemini Outdoors. And I know this is a touchy subject. Let's try to keep things civil, even though I know that, you know, it's going to be hard. Anyway, y'all have a good one. We'll see you in the next video.